Holy Spirit, we welcome you this morning to just have your way, to heal, to touch, to set free, to deliver, to encourage the hearts and the minds of your people, to break every generational curse, every generational stronghold, every attack of the enemy is called null, void, and harmless in Jesus' name. You said the gates of hell shall not prevail against your church. And when the enemy comes, your spirit, let them stand against it, Father God. So we thank you right now, Father God, that it is written. And that's just how you defeated the enemy when he came to tempt you for 40 days. You defeated him with the word. You left us the example of how to stand in complete and absolute victory in the face of trying times, Father God. And we thank you right now, Father God, that we are more than conquerors through you. That means we win big, Father, and we have a parade. So, Father, we thank you right now that we will continue to occupy until you return. Continue, Father God, to share the gospel, the good news, Father God, of your grace and your mercy, Father God, for your people. We give you and you alone all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise due to your name. In Jesus' mighty, precious name, amen. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. We're going to read the Psalms 93. Hallelujah. It's not long, but it's going to be strong. It says, the Lord reigneth. He is clothed with majesty. The Lord is clothed with strength, wherewith he has girded himself. The world also is stabilized. That is, cannot be moved. Thy throne is established of old. Thou art from everlasting. The floods have lifted up, O Lord. The floods lifted up their voice. The flood lifted up their waves. The Lord on high is mightier than the noise of many waters, yea, than the mighty waves of the sea. Thy testimonies are very sure. Holiness becometh thine house, O Lord, forever. May the Lord have a blessing, reading, hearing, and doing of his holy word. Bed.
God's got a blessing.
I got a blessing.
With your name on it. No difference what you're going through. You're gonna make it. God's gonna see through. Hold your head up. Put a smile on your face. This is another test. It won't last always. So get ready.
Get ready.
For your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready.
For your miracle.
For your miracle.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
I know you've been hurting deep down inside. Let me encourage you. It's gonna be alright. Troubles and trials come to make you strong. Keep on believing. You keep holding on. And get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. God's got a blessing.
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 Oh! God's got a blessing.
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 With your name on it.
With your name on it.
God's got a blessing.
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 With your name on it.
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 With your name.
Got a blessing with your name on it. All right. God's got a blessing with your name on it. All you gotta do is reach up and grab it. With long life, you will satisfy me. He will satisfy me with long life. satisfy me. He will satisfy me, Lord, with long life. I will praise you forever. Only you can satisfy. Oh,
with long life, you will satisfy me. You will satisfy me.
With long life.
With long life. With long life.
You will.
You will satisfy me. You will satisfy me.
With long life.
Long life,
I will
praise you forever.
Only you can satisfy. With long life,
you will satisfy me. You will satisfy me.
With long life,
with long life, you will satisfy
me. You will.
Me. You will satisfy
with
me.
With long life,
I will praise you forever.
Only you can satisfy.
I'm satisfied.
I will. presence.
In your presence.
I'm satisfied.
I'm satisfied.
I will live.
I will live.
And not die.
And not die.
In your presence.
In your presence.
I'm satisfied.
I'm satisfied.
I will live.
I will live.
And not die.
And not die.
Oh! With long life.
With long life. You will satisfy me. You will satisfy me.
With long life.
With long life.
With long life.
You will satisfy
me.
You will satisfy me.
With long life.
With long life.
I will.
I will.
Praise.
Forever.
Only you,
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 can satisfy. God's grace. How did it make it all these years? How did it make it this far? Through the valleys and over the hills. I know it had to be God. How did it make it through the storm? How did it make it through the rain? If you want to know just how I got here, it's so easy to explain. It was God's grace.
God's grace.
God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing grace.
God's grace.
I made it this far.
I made it this far. Grace of God.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
God's grace.
God's grace.
God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing grace.
God's grace.
I made it this far.
I made it this far. By the grace.
How you brought me, how you brought me through the night. Lord, you kept me, you never left me. You stood by my side. There's so many times I came so close. Oh, my death, he tried to pull me in. But the reason why I'm here, not hard to see. In fact, it's so easy, easy for me to explain. It was God's grace.
God's grace.
God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing grace.
God's grace.
I made it this far.
I made it this far. By the grace of God.
I remember the times when I strayed away. Even though I knew the word, still I wouldn't obey. But God's grace and mercy carried me and kept me all the way.
God's grace.
I made it this far.
By the grace of God.
God's grace.
His
amazing grace.
God's grace.
I made it this far.
By the grace of God.
Anybody want to know?
Was God's grace.
Just how I got here.
God's grace.
Anybody want to know?
God's grace.
Still standing.
God's grace.
I made it this far.
By the grace.
People said
it was God's grace.
They said I wouldn't make it.
God's grace.
Some people said
God's grace.
I wouldn't be here today.
It was God's grace.
But I made it.
I made it this far. By the grace of God. God's grace.
I made it this far.
I made it this far.
grace and your mercy. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Above all. This is our worship. Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth.
Crucified, lay above all.
Thank you, Lord.
Before we round up, we're going to all stand and honor what God has done in this country all these years. In the song that we're going to sing, the Lord has given us liberty. He has given us harmony. He has given us peace, joy. I just want us to stand as we reverence the goodness of God in this country. We lift every voice and sing.
Lift every voice
and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the lift. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought. Facing the rising sun of a new day begun, let us march on to victory.
Drunk with the wine of the world we've
Divine, we are declaring it, Lord, that we will stand on your word concerning this country, Heavenly Father. That is in you we stand, Heavenly Father, Lord. We will stand true to our God in every situation. We will not give room to the devil. Lord, therefore, we are declaring United States of America stands on God. I will not be a communist country, Lord. I will not be referred to as Sodom and Gomorrah. United States of America stands on God, Jehovah. I will not destroy the innocent. I will not kill the innocent. In the name of Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, we thank you. We stand true to our God, Heavenly Father, Lord. Your love being made manifest in every law, in everything that they pass. In the name of Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, that righteousness will continuously reign in United States of America, that the righteous will lead in the name of Jesus Christ, that the United States of America will not be referred to as Sodom and Gomorrah, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. We glorify your holy name. Lord, indeed, we will not stray from the places that you have led us in this country, Heavenly Father. Our hearts will not be drunk with the wine of this world. Lord, the vine, but rather, Lord, we will remain drunk in you, Lord, in your word and in your righteousness and in your goodness. Father, we thank you and we thank you and we thank you. Be exalted, Papa. Be glorified, Jehovah. Be magnified, Jehovah. In Jesus' name we have declared, amen and amen. Amen. It's time for our communion. It's time for us to remember what Jesus Christ did for us. I want you today in particular to reflect on the word of lift every voice and sing. It reminds you of what God has done for us. Just reflect on the word. Don't give it any other baptismal name. Just reflect on it. And allow the Holy Spirit to minister it to you. I just want you to believe that Jesus Christ finished it all. It is finished, Jesus said. It is finished. And because he said it is finished, it is finished. Believe it, and those of you at home, go on and join us. Go on and join us with all the elements, any of the elements that you are using. Believe it, Jesus has finished it. There's nothing too hard for him. What men say is impossible, he makes it possible. What men never envisaged they can ever achieve or can ever happen, God knows how to make it happen. So when he says it is finished, it is finished. Just choose to believe it. I choose to believe it. And it works. It is finished. It is finished. He is the healer. It is finished. He takes care of every disease. It is finished. It is finished. Just believe it, it is finished. God never fails. I am so sure of it. He never fails. He never fails. It is finished. The body of Jesus Christ broken, that our body will not be broken. The blood of Jesus Christ shed, and Jesus Christ himself washed us with his blood and made us kings and priests unto God the Father. I want you, as you hold those elements, just choose to believe it. It is finished. Let's go on and stand as we make the confession together. I hold this bread before you, Lord, as a reminder of your body, which was broken for me. I thank you for bearing all of my diseases and pain. I number myself among the healed. My body is the tabernacle of God, not the house of disease. As I eat this bread in faith, I remember you. And by your suffering, I am healed today. Let's partake together. And hold the cup as we make the confession together. I hold this cup of wine before you, Lord, as a reminder of your blood, which was shed for me. Thank you for paying the price for all my sins. You bore my guilt and shame. I now have dignity. I number myself among the righteous. I am redeemed. As I drink this cup in faith, I remember you. By your blood, I am clean today. Let's partake together. Let's raise up our hands in thanksgiving unto God. Thank you, Jesus. I do remember you. Thank you for my healing. Thank you for my salvation. Thank you that I am in fellowship with you. Thank you that I am one with my brothers and sisters. Thank you for your life that is in us. In Jesus' name, amen. Father, we thank you. Your life is in us. And we are just saying thank you over and over. Be exalted. Your life is in us, and so we will live long and fulfill lives here on this earth, in this land of the living. Thank you, Jehovah. In Jesus' name we have declared. Amen. Amen. It's time for our offering. And I'm going to encourage you, those of you in church, if you pick up the bulletin, the one-leaf bulletin, and you open where we have the daily Bible reading. At the bottom of it, you see some QR codes. We have now included the QR code for your giving so that you don't need to start looking for where is the church track, where is the link. Just go on and use your phone, scan that QR code, and you'll be able to give. We now have the QR code together with some of the confessional statements that Bishop has already written for our healing. I want you to believe it. Believe it. That Bishop wrote it. Just take it. I'm going to quickly share this before we give our offering. A nurse, called me and said, please, the sister is not feeling fine. And she said, please, can you all pray for me? And I'm like, why do you want us to pray for you? So just tell the church, just make sure you tell the bishop. I said, I'm going to tell you something. The bishop doesn't know who you are. I don't actually know you that much. I just know your name. The name you told me that is your name, that's as much I know. So why on earth did you have to figure out? Because it's not like I see this person. But this person had to have gone to an extreme to be able to get my contact number, to be able to call. That's why I'm sharing it. And I need you to hear what she told me. She said, there is this case of this lady that everybody knew wasn't going to make it. said everybody knew that she wasn't going to make it. But one of your pastors came and prayed. And from seeing the everything in the ICU going to leveling to zero level, which means everything giving up, he said somehow everything jumped back to normal. And this person is alive, sound, and healthy. And he said, based on that, I want your church to pray also. But I will tell you exactly what happened. When they called me for this particular situation that the person was, everything was going zero, I don't want to call the name of the person so that the person can give their thanksgiving when they are ready and tell their stories by themselves. But when they called me, I will tell you two things I did. It was very wonderful that they called me when it was church service. I ran to the church. I said, God, what am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? When everybody, the nurses, they just want the family to come. The end has come. I said, no, you don't determine the end. You are not God. I said, God, what will I do? God said, give. I had some little money in my purse, which I wanted to keep for my own use. But the Lord said, give. And then the Lord said, go on, tell the bishop. I ran in and told Bishop, I said, this person is not feeling fine. He's in the, I didn't give Bishop the details. I just said, this person is not feeling fine. He's in the hospital. Bishop, can you pray? He said, who is there? I said, can you just pray for this person? That's all I wanted to do. And then I rushed out because I had to be on the phone. And they said, you have a few minutes. Everything is reading. This person is basically, the machine is just what is keeping this person going. And I turned, I screamed, and Pastor Michael was already on his way. He said he's going to the hospital. And I don't know whether he knew how bad it was. But they were, I was on that phone. I said, God. God, I've given. You said, give. I put whatever God told me to put in the envelope and quickly dropped it. I don't think it was suffering time yet. I just dropped it and ran out. And I was like, God, we are not burying anybody. 2024, we are not. Nobody is dying. I don't know how many seconds Bishop prayed. Maybe she prayed 1 second or two. It's not the length of the time of the prayer that was important. The point is that she prayed. And when she prayed, because she had to continue Grace Encounter. After she prayed, she came out and continued with the Grace Encounter. And I stood out there. And I kept going, God. And nothing happened immediately. But it was like less than 30 minutes. I got the call. They said, oh, Pastor Michael prayed and it has left. But the reading came back up. He said the reading came back up. The blood pressure has gotten to 60. That tells you it was below 60, right? He said it has gotten up to 60, and it looks like it's rising. I said it's going to rise to normalcy. I say it's going to rise. And as of yesterday, I went to see this person. This person was back to being fussy, and I'm like, for real? I said, for real? I said, don't fuss over anything, chill. And I'm like, don't just start, chill, okay? And I looked at it, I started laughing. I said, this is the person men give up to, on. And God said, it's not yet time. I'm saying this so that you give by faith and know that your giving speaks. And you believe God for the anointing that flows from the head. I believe all of them tied up together. That's why I said in the bulletin you have, I'm just emphasizing this because it had been in my spirit all through last night. When this person said, let your church pray. And I remembered, I told this person, I'll bring something that you, if you believe it, you will receive the miracles. In our warm leaf pamphlet we have, just go there and you will see the QR codes. go on the QR codes and be able to listen and read those scriptures, because it's from the bishop. The anointing flows from the head to the down. Let's go on and speak over our offering, our tithes. Believe God for the miraculous. The God I'm talking about never fails. He will not fail you. Father, we thank you. We bless you that we have the privilege of giving. Be exalted for such privilege of giving in this sanctuary. In Jesus' name we have declared. Amen. Let's go on and make the offering confession of faith together. Heavenly Father, we profess this day unto you that we have come into the inheritance which you swore to give us. We are in the land which you have provided for us in Jesus Christ, the kingdom of Almighty God. We were sinners serving Satan. He was our God. But we called upon the name of Jesus, and you heard our cry and delivered us from the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of your dear Son, Jesus, as our Lord and High Priest. We bring the first fruit of our income to you, that you may worship the Lord our God with them. Father, we rejoice in all the good which you have given to us and our households. We have heard your voice and have done according to all that you have commanded us. Now, Father, as you look down from your holy habitation from heaven to bless us as you said in your word, we believe that we now receive those blessings according to your word. This is our confession of faith in Jesus' name. Amen. Father, we believe it and we receive it and we say thank you. Be exalted, Jehovah. In Jesus' name we have declared. Amen and amen. Before Pastor Michael takes over, let me quickly run through this announcement. We have the education scholarship fundraising today, 1 p.m. immediately after second service. I'm going to encourage everybody to be here and participate in what God is doing. And we do it in tribute to Pastor Marco Ranusi and Pastor Emily Udo that have gone to rest 3 years ago. So we continuously do it and use it to help those that are in need. I want you not to forget that this Friday, we are going to have all-night prayers starting 9. In actual fact, I tell people it's starting 7, because 7 you come is great, is grace encounter. Hear the word of God that will get you boosted. I call it having dinner with the bishop. Come and have a dinner. Just come and have a dinner time with the bishop. And ironically, I found out that there was dinner this last Friday. I didn't mean it as dinner food, but I came into the church. It was dinner. I'm like, for real? Okay, I must have said something right. So there was dinner. I meant dinner of the word of God. No, that's the truth. That's what I meant when I called some people and said, come and have dinner with Bishop. It's at 7 p.m. I didn't mean literally food you eat. But I came and then Bishop said, oh, Reverend Chidinlo, there is dinner. I'm like, I didn't mean that type of dinner. But I went and looked, for real, there was dinner. But that wasn't what I meant. But I want you to come this Friday. Come to have dinner with Bishop. His grace encounter before all night prayer starts at 9 p.m. Let's have a dinner time where we are full with the word of God and we can utilize that word in our prayers. It starts 9 p.m. That's our first all night prayers for the year 2024. And we have all the services Monday. We have prophetic prayers. And the following week, I'll keep announcing, Bishop and the team will be going to Philippines. And we're going to possess the country of Philippines for Christ. All north and south, I know they have different areas. But we will possess it for Christ. Pastor Michael.
Hallelujah. 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 God is good. All the time. Amen. I'd like you to join me in singing a song. Jesus on the inside, walking on the outside. Oh, what a pain in my life. Jesus on the inside, walking on the outside. Oh, what a change in my life. Jesus on the inside, walking on the outside. Oh, what a change in my life. Oh, what a change in my life. Amen? Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for that which you are doing on the inside of us, that which you are going to perfect. We thank you, for we see it and we are glad. We thank you, O Lord, for today, for the opportunity to gather together in your presence, to hear from you. We ask, O Lord, that you open our hearts to receive your word. That your word will change us. Your word will perfect us. Your word will direct us. Speak through me, O Lord, that word. That your name, O Lord, will be glorified. Thank you for doing it. Take all the glory, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I would like us to turn to Philippians chapter 4. We're going to read verse 6. Philippians 4, 6 and 7. Philippians 4, 6 and 7. Are you there? It says, be careful for nothing. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Amen? And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. If you are careful for nothing. Amen. 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 And you will not be careful for nothing. That means you won't worry. Unless you invite God into your affairs. Isn't that what he says there? But in everything, ask him. In everything, invite him to take control. And then you start thanking him, for it is done. Amen? So today we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about how to live a worry-free life. How to be at peace no matter what you're going through. Worry is a mental distress that results from concerns that people have, whether it's imaginary or real. of something that is impending or anticipated. That might happen at all, may not happen at all. Worry is a mind that is not at rest. Divided mind, not knowing what to do. Torn between real and the possibilities. Between the immediate and the potentials. So you are thinking all these thoughts of what might or might not be. And that's causing you to worry. And here it says, do not worry. But rather than worry in everything, take it to God in prayer. Why worry when you can pray? Trust in Jesus, and he will lead the way. Isn't that what it says? That particular song tells us a lot. That if you are worrying, that means you are not trusting God. Or you cannot pray. You don't know how to pray. Of course, you cannot pray if you don't have a heavenly Father you go to. Well, let's go to Matthew. Matthew 6. We're going to read verse 25 through 31. Matthew 6, 25 through 31. There are a lot of things that happen in life that will cause you to worry. But today, we are told, we are commanded not to worry. Verse 25, Matthew 6. Let's read together. Therefore, I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body. What ye shall put on, is not the life more than meat, and the body more than raiment? Behold the fowls of the earth, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? Which of you, by taking thoughts, can add one cubit unto his stature? And why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. And yet I say unto you, that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Wherefore, if God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? Amen? Commanded not to worry. And here, Jesus is giving us four reasons why not to worry. Four reasons. The first one we found on the first verse we read. It says, therefore I say unto you, take no thoughts. That means do not worry. For your life, what you shall eat, or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than the meat or the dress? See what he's saying there? You're worrying about what you're going to eat or drink, rather than worrying for the fact that you are alive. Not that you should worry about that either, but he's saying that your worry is unreasonable. Worrying doesn't make sense. So stop worrying. Worrying exaggerates the problem. Worrying doesn't solve the problem. Actually, worrying doesn't add to your life, but rather it takes away. If you continue worrying, you will get sick. So stop worrying. It makes no sense. Worrying about things that doesn't add up. The second reason he gave us, we see on verse 26. It says, behold, the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father, stop there. It says, yet your heavenly Father, you do know you have a heavenly Father who loves you, who cares about you. Think about this. Fathers are the ones that take care of the provisions for the kids. Isn't that true? All that the kids know to do is they go to the refrigerator, open the door, and grab what they want to eat. And if nothing is there, what do? They run to mommy. What happened here? I'm hungry. No food. Your heavenly Father, who cares about you, who loves you very much, is there. And then he goes on to say, your heavenly Father is one that takes care of all these things. They toil not, they spin not. Your heavenly Father takes care of them. If he does, why wouldn't he take care of you? Or you think he doesn't love you? Or you think he doesn't care about you? Or you think he doesn't know that you have need for all these? Are ye not much more better than they? So he's saying here that worrying is unnatural. Naturally, you shouldn't be worrying because you have a heavenly Father. So if you're worrying, you are saying that you don't have a heavenly Father. Or you don't know that you have a heavenly Father. Or you are acting unnaturally. Because little babes do not worry. All they do is they cry. And as soon as they start crying, you're going to feed them. They're not worrying about where the food is coming from. Gotta feed them. See, worrying is learned. It's a bad habit that is learned. So natural. When you're born, you're not born a warrior. If there's a word like that. You grow up. You carry all these things in your shoulders that you have no business carrying. You see, all you are doing is making yourself sick. because it's not natural. If it's unnatural, then it's not good for you. Actually, the Word of God says that. Let's go to Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 25. Are you there? Proverbs 12, 25. Says, heaviness in the heart of man maketh it stoop. Causes depression. Makes it stoop. Causes anxiety. Causes problems. Heaviness, worry. But a good word maketh it glad. If you keep on worrying, all you're doing is just making yourself depressed, sick. So if you don't want to get sick, be happy. Let the peace of God guard your heart. Amen? 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 So if you want to stay healthy, stop worrying. The third reason Jesus gave, we find on verse 27 of that same text, Matthew 6. It says, which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit to your stature? Can you make yourself a little bit taller by worrying? I don't even think you can add one more hair to Mike's head by worrying. You can't do that. So worrying is unhelpful. It doesn't help you. It cannot change the situation. Worrying cannot change the past. It's yesterday, you can bring it back. It does not control the future. The only thing worrying does is affect you. That's all it does. It changes your outlook. It makes you miserable. It causes your heart to stoop, brings sickness to you. Gives you ulcer, clouds your judgment, keeps you in one place. You can't see past your nose. That's all worry does. You can think straight. It's unhelpful. That's what Jesus is saying. Remember, all this I in red. Jesus is speaking. If it's unhelpful, why worry? After hearing all this, are you going to continue to worry? Amen? And the fourth reason Jesus said you shouldn't worry, we see on verse 30. says, wherefore, if God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? If God, who loves you so much, that he sent his only begotten son to die for you, to pay the penalty that you could not pay, if he takes care of every other thing else that are inconsequential, why wouldn't he take care of you? So he's saying here that worrying is unnecessary when you know you have an heavenly Father who loves you. Worrying is unnecessary when you know that you have access to everything you need. Worrying is unnecessary when all you need to do is call and ask, Daddy, I need this. And it's done. Because he can. But if you know all this and you keep on worrying, that means one thing. No faith. Or very little faith. But you know what? If you have little faith, it can move mountains. So it's no faith. O ye of little faith, why worry? So worrying is unnecessary when you can cast your burden unto the Lord. By the way, let's read that. Peter chapter 5. Peter 5, verse 7. First Peter 5, 7. Are you there? Says what? Casting all your cares upon him, for he careth for you. Do you know that God cares very much about you? Yeah, he loves you that much. That every single thing you're going through, he cares about it. He sent his son. His son came that you may have life and have it more abundantly. Not for you to worry about things when you can have all that you need and have it in abundance. Here on our test, if we were counting, you see that Jesus specifically said, do not worry, at least 3 times. The first one on verse 25 we read. Therefore I say unto you, take no thought or do not worry for your life. The second one he says on verse 31. Therefore take no thought. Do not worry. What you shall eat or what you shall drink or what you shall wear. And the third one we see on verse 34. Therefore, take no thought. Do not worry for tomorrow. For tomorrow shall have its own problems. Don't worry about it. These are commands he's giving us. He is our Lord. And if he's your own Lord, obey. Do not worry. By issuing these commands, Jesus is letting us know it's a choice we have to choose to make. It's up to us to choose to obey. See, he loves us so much, and love requires choice. So he's letting us know we are not to worry, but you choose to obey him or not. With all that said, how do we live here being obedient to that law? How do we live here free from worry? What are we going to do so that we will stop worrying? Because it's one thing to say, it's another to put it to practice. And the whole idea of all this is so that you go out and put it in practice. Amen? 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 Yeah. Amen? Yeah. Well, there are three keys. Three keys that we can apply. And all of them are found in the same text. The first one is on verse 27. It says, which of you by taking thoughts can add one cubit unto his stature? Which of you? What he's really saying is, one, resolve to let go of things you can't do much about. Yeah. If you cannot do anything about it, there's nothing you can do about it. Leave it alone. Leave it alone. Hand it over to God. That's really what he's saying. What are we called to do? Walk by faith, not by sight. If you look at the way things look, you will worry. But if your focus is on Christ, if your focus is on his word, if you are looking at your big God, your problem becomes minute. You know, in the word of God, we have examples of what happened to the people of Israel. God said, I've given you this land. And they sent him 10 spies. 8 of them were looking at the giants in the land, while only two that are walking in faith saw their big God, and the giants became like grasshoppers. If you keep on looking at all that's around you, if you keep on listening to what the doctor said, if you keep on looking at the economy of the land, you end up worrying. But what you need to do is resolve to let go of situations that you cannot control, that you cannot do anything about. Know that God can. Know that God is able. Know that nothing takes him by surprise. Actually, he specializes on the impossibilities. Because when he does it, he alone will get the glory. When he does it, everyone will know that he did it. Oh, yes. So let go of every situation that is out of your control. Second Corinthians chapter 5 verse 7 tells us, we've said it already, but let's read it again. says, for we walk by faith, not by sight. For we, children of God, who are born again believers, walk by what the word of God says. Believe God at his word. Allow the word to be the light on our path, to direct our footsteps. Believe that we are overcomers no matter what the enemy does, no matter how it looks. And if you do, you will not worry. It doesn't matter how impossible it looks. The second thing, by the way, I need to, let's go to the second one. The second one we find also on the text, chapter 6, verse 34. It says, take therefore no thought for the morrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. Take no thought for tomorrow. So if you do not want to worry, you have to resolve to live tomorrow alone. Yes. Resolve to live tomorrow alone. Does that mean you should not plan? No. Actually, planning is a demonstration of your faith. So you should plan. I didn't say you shouldn't plan. If you do not plan, you plan to fail. Yes. Very simple. Does it mean you should not prepare? No, of course you should prepare. You should get all the education you need. You should walk in excellence in everything you do. And you can't do that unless you prepare. You don't shoot from the hip. You take time, you become vigilant in everything you do. Be the best in all that you do. And that requires preparation. Take no thought for tomorrow. Does it mean you shouldn't set goals? No. Of course you should set goals. If you don't set goals, you wouldn't know when you hit it because you don't have any goals. You'll be going back and forth, jack of all trades, master of. You should set goals. So it's okay to set goals, but it's not okay to worry. No. Don't worry about tomorrow. Do what you have to do today to your best ability. Leave tomorrow alone. Amen? So the first key, resolve to let go of situations you have any control over, but rather hand it over to God. Second one is resolve to leave tomorrow alone. Amen? 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 Amen. 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 Deal with whatever life hands you today. Deal with it to the best of your ability. Seek God's counsel so that you walk smart. You are efficient. You are good at what you do. leave tomorrow alone. Let's take a look at Isaiah. Isaiah 26. Verse 3. Isaiah 26, 3. Are you there? It says, thou will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusted thee. See, for you to live tomorrow alone, you have to put your trust in the Lord. That he is able to take care of your tomorrows. And when your trust is on him, your mind is at peace. He knows tomorrow. He has gone before you to make all crooked ways straight. Why worry when he is awake? Why worry when he is doing all the work? Why worry when he has already fought all the battles and won? Unless your trust is not on him. If your trust is on him, if your focus is on Christ, your heart will be at peace. See, thou will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on him. So if you are worrying, that means your eyes are not stayed on Christ. That means you're not putting your trust on God. So you cannot walk by faith. You remember, trust is one of the elements of faith. Remember, a long time ago we talked about it. You cannot walk by faith if your trust is not on God. If you are putting your trust on yourself or on man, man will fail you. You will fail yourself. So you are worrying because you don't even trust God. That's why. That's what it is. That's what it is. So resolve to let go of situations you don't have any control over. Resolve to live tomorrow in God's hands. If you do, you will not worry. Because the third reason or the third key is to do what? Pray. Resolve to pray rather than worry. Why worry when you can pray? Trust in Jesus and he will lead the way. Don't be the doubting Thomas, but trusting on his promise. Why worry, 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 when you can pray? Talking about your predicaments to everyone out there, whether they ask you or not, you are boring them. They wish to run away, but they are trying to be nice. Why? When you can go straight to God, the one that can change things for you, the one that has all the solutions, the one that has all the time for you, the one that is not really bored, wants to hear you. That loves you. That knows what you are going through even before you open your mouth. Why not go to him and tell him? Why? Go talk to your Heavenly Father. He's the one that can change things for you. So pray. Pray rather than worry. Let's go to James chapter 2. James 4 verse 2. What does it say? You don't have because you don't ask, isn't it? If you don't ask, you will not receive. That's really what it's saying there. You adulterers, you lust and have not. You kill and desire to have and cannot obtain. Ye fight and war, yet ye have not, because why do all these things when you can just simply ask? Ask him. See, people do not ask because they are so proud. That's the problem. You don't take the time to humble yourself. Walk in humility. Say that you have need. That you are not able to do it by yourself. That you need assistance. And ask for help. Yes. That's all it takes. You don't have to have your lips cleaved to the roof of your mouth because you don't want to walk in humility. And ask. See, that's the problem. If you're not asking your Heavenly Father, it's because you are walking in pride. And you know what? He hates the proud. And rather than helping you, he will resist you. So ask. Until you ask, you will not receive. Why worry when you can simply ask for help from the one that really wants to help you? From the one who is able to help you. Ask. Romans chapter 8, verse 2. Let's go there quickly. See, he has given you more than you can even ask him. Giving you more than you can ever deserve. Actually, you don't even deserve any of it. You know, he gave it anyway. Romans chapter 8, verse 32. Says, he that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also give freely all things? He gave you more than you can ever deserve, more than you can ever ask. Why worry when you can ask him all the things that he can easily give you, freely give you? He loves you very much. He loves us very much. He wants to show himself off on us. Amen? And to cap it up, it says on Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, 7. Let's go there. And that will be our time is up, but let's go there. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 and 7. It says what? Be careful for nothing, But in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, will guard your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. Be careful for nothing. Worry about nothing. But pray about everything. Worry about nothing. Pray about everything. If you're worrying, you're not praying. You cannot be praying and be worrying. Impossible. Let us pray. So that we don't worry. Amen? 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 Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. Thank you for each and everyone that has heard. We ask, O Lord, let your peace that passeth all understanding guard our hearts and minds, that our eyes will be focused on you. That everything that we do, Heavenly Father, we will present to you first, so that you will direct our footsteps. That your name, O Lord, will be magnified. Thank you for doing it. Take all the glory, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Shall we say the grace together? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever and ever. Amen. The Lord is good all the time. Go in peace.
OCN, Word of God to the World.